Welcome to Warn. Today's news is: Defense PSUs are reinventing themselves. Public sector defense companies, the backbone of India's indigenous defense production, presented a picture of overall optimism at the Aero India 2017. Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, HAL, India's premier defense aerospace manufacturer, displayed its combat aircraft like the Tejas and the license-produced Psu-30 Mki, and helicopters like the Dhruv ALH, light combat helicopter, and the light utility helicopter. They unveiled the huge Indian multi-role helicopter, IMRH, with an impressive full-scale mock-up. Beyond these were the HTT-40 turboprop basic trainer and the old HJT-16 Kiran, and other major license-produced engines. HAL's Tejas is, at last, approaching final operational clearance before entering service. While its limited payload/range performance restricts its ground attack capability, its exceptional agility makes Tejas ideal for air defense. As for exports, the supersonic advanced jet trainer variant may be more exportable than the fighter. The rejection of the overweight naval Tejas was a setback, but things are being sorted out. A total of 40 Tejas Mk1 and 83 upgraded Mk1As are on firm order for the IAF. HAL still does not have an in-house design capability for engines. That is to be rectified with the design of two technology demonstrators, the HTFE-25 turbofan and the HTSE-1200 turboshaft helicopter engine. HAL could, someday, develop large engines for fighters and helicopters of its own design. However, HAL still needs to enhance quality control as well as maintainability and reliability of its products, some of which, like the intermediate jet trainer, have fallen by the wayside. The Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, set up to develop cutting-edge technologies for the armed forces, has a mind-boggling total production value of Rs 2,060,000 crore. DRDO has under it over 50 organizations. Its Aeronautical Development Agency, ADA, had designed the Tejas, and is to start design work on the Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft, AMCA. The AMCA is to incorporate fifth-generation technology, including stealth not excluding radar, absorbent paint. That is a trifle ambitious. Two foreign manufacturers have offered to help, but they themselves have no experience of stealth. Another DRDO product is the Airborne Early Warning and Control, AEWANC, system. It has multiple sensors mounted atop Brazilian Embraer 145 aircraft. DRDO's Defense Research and Development Laboratory works on a range of advanced missiles, including the Akash medium-range surface-to-air missile, the Astra Beyond Visual Range air-to-air missile for LCA and ACMA, and the much-delayed NAG anti-tank missile. Interestingly, the deadliest missile in the Indian arsenal is the Indo-Russian BrahMos Mach 3 cruise missile. It can be launched from land, sea or air. In the terminal stage of its flight against a ship, it can dive to sea skimming height to avoid detection and interception. A number of these missiles can sink an aircraft carrier. Work continues on the Agni family of ballistic missiles, some able to carry nuclear warheads. In an advanced stage is a two-tier ballistic missile defense system, with low and high-altitude interceptor missiles, realistically tested against a Prithvi ballistic missile. DRDO claims that India is one of the only 5 countries in the world to have a ballistic missile defense program. Not every program progresses smoothly to completion though. The nearby 1,000 km range subsonic cruise missile had several failures, and was cancelled, but is being resurrected. It is also more vulnerable to interception than supersonic cruise missiles like BrahMos. Another defense behemoth, Bharat Electronics Limited, BEL, makes defense electronics for every Indian aircraft, naval ship, missile and land vehicles. For Tejas, it makes 9 items of equipment including the digital flight control computer and the radar warning receiver. Its very diversified product range includes radars, electronic warfare equipment, identification friend or foe, head-up displays, and electro-optical devices. Such products have also been used to upgrade older aircraft like the Jaguar and Mirage 2000. The Council for Scientific and Industrial Research had set up the National Aerospace Laboratories, NAL, for research and development as well as design work. Their trisonic wind tunnel helps with high-speed aerodynamics research for HAL, DRDO and the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. NAL's advanced Psu'S turboprop aircraft, which had a fatal 2009 crash, was scrapped, and then resurrected. India's aerospace industry has some good products, but is not yet world class. That should be its main objective. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, warn.